Alrighty, time for round one here. I would, in fact, like to play first. Well, I've got a mulligan in that hand. And apparently, I don't get to scry quite yet. Soon enough. And as for my opening hand, what do I do here? Because I can play a turn one Everflowing Chalice for one. And then that lets me play turn two Shackles. Or just more realistically, leave up Condescend. Yeah, that's probably good enough. I think that waiting to play a Chalice for two is probably a bit greedy here. I think if I play Chalice for one and pass, this just gets me to five very quickly, and don't think I need to wait multiple turns in order to hit Chalice for two here. So let's go ahead and play that. Island. I'm just gonna pass the turn. I would rather be able to condescend my opponent's play. Also, if my opponent plays a one power creature, then I can shackles it. Land. I think I just pass. Not really sure what my opponent is up to here, but I'd rather wait. I could play Legacies of Lore. Maybe that's worth it. I guess I'd have to know more about the opposing deck. The problem with playing Legacies of Lore is my opponent then gets to play something, and they could have even just had a counterspell right there. All right, lots of colors. Let's see what this is. Goblin Rabble Master. No. We're not doing that. Condescend for one. Let's see what we can hit here. So, four color Rabble Master, interesting. Put a mountain on the bottom, I'll put the Royal on top. And then my plan is to play a Legacies of Lore. I could play a Shackles, but I think I can wait on that. And then next turn, play Shackles. Actually, you know what? I'm just going to play the Shackles. I'll take my two damage. This way, I have a mana up to use into the Royal here. Now, if my opponent plays a creature, then I've got a good chance of just being able to steal it pretty soon. Let's see if there's a planeswalker. Plus, in QR is actually not going to be that problematic for me because I can into the Royal it once it becomes an issue here. Think I'll just wait, maybe into the Royal at end of turn here. All right, my opponent. Actually, I'm just gonna wait another turn because my opponent looks like they're interested in ultimating. Opposition. Uh-oh. That explains the Rabble Master. Oh. Yeah, let's use Legacy's ability. Ooh. All right. Yeah, let's play Keranos. Leaving some mana up here. Keranos actually seems awesome right here because Keranos. If I draw a non-land, I can just shoot Kiora for three. And at some point, I can end the Royal here. Also, Legacies of Lore in opposition. Actually, no, I guess I can't shoot Kiora for three because of. That's funny. Because of Kiora's actual ability. Mono Planeswalkers, what is going on here? Alright. And my opponent has three actual forests. Alright. This will be a thing, but I guess my opponent's just never gonna play a creature. A four forest, that's a taiga, that's not even a plateau. Jeez. Alright, I'm gonna wait on into the Royal because I want to cast it with Kicker here. Alright, cast it on Kiora with Kicker. Again, still leaves me enough to cast Electrolyze. Oh, Jace the Mind Sculptor. All right, it's gonna be a this is going to be a battle of the Planeswalkers. That is for sure. So Kiora's coming down, and then I get to Electrolyze Kiora probably since, well, Nissa's Ultimate's also threatening, but opponent's a little further away from Nissa though. I guess wait. Oh, what just, oh, why did I, oh man. I could have electrolyzed in response to the temple trigger. My opponent should definitely not have done that. And I could have just killed Kiora. Holy crap, that was bad. I am bad on both of our parts. My opponent shouldn't have played a temple, and I certainly shouldn't have let this happen. Oh, I could have killed Kiora, and then Karandos could have destroyed Nissa, or at least put Nissa down to one. Wow, that was heinous. All right, let's try not to do that again, shall we? Man, it is a gift. I was offered a gift, a generous one, and I turned it down. And that is my fault. All right, so probably gonna electrolyze. Still reducing it, or putting Kiora down to one here. Let's see what Nissa does here. So Nissa's going to 5. 6, 7, ultimate. Kiora's going to 3, so 4, 5, ultimate. Actually, I don't know whose ultimate is worse. I think Nissa's might actually be worse. All right, well, let's electrolyze my opponent. And actually think I'm redirecting to Nissa. Untap. Hopefully drawing a land here. Oh, upheaval is actually great because that's kind of my plan here. All right, so let's play Jace. I'll just take two more damage probably. I'm just gonna casually take millions of damage. All right, I'm gonna draw three. The one thing my opponent does not seem to have is permission, which is nice. And so now I can make sure I draw land for Karanos here. My opponent probably actually has a bunch of creatures in hand that they can't play because of Legacy of Lore and Vidalkin Shackles. Would not surprise me. All right, what is this? So next turn I might upheaval. So I'll get to have 6, 7, 8 mana Siege Gang Commander. Okay. Vidalkin Shackles the Siege Gang Commander in response to the trigger here. I assume my opponent's going to sacrifice it here. I guess I could have left red up. But I don't know if what my opponent thinks is going to happen. But it's not that they get to throw a bunch of goblins at me. So they're knocking Jace down to 1. We'll find out. And I'm still protected from a Nissa land because of Legacy of Lore, but this does speed up my clock for upheaval. So now I get to go 4, 5, 6, upheaval. Basically, have 9 mana after I upheaval. And then I can replay Ancient Tomb if I want to play. So I just took 2 there. Play Chalice though. Actually, I could just go land Chalice for 2, and then next turn land Jace, next turn land Karanos. That seems pretty good. Okay. My opponent's plusing things. Actually, I guess I can't quite do that because of my opponent's millions of creatures here. Am I going to be able to cast Upheaval at all? Well, I actually think I will because I get to steal Noble Hierarch. And that gives me extra, basically two extra mana sources here. Since now my opponent taps down 3 lands and I can still cast Upheaval, just won't be as good for me. But I assume I want to at some point here. Tapping Ancient Tomb, sure. Mountain. And yeah, I guess Noble Hierarch. Alright, so I'm gonna draw off Karanos. I'm gonna draw again. Probably just gonna keep drawing cards here. So I can go land Upheaval. That's pretty bad. So let's not do that. And I'm at 8, so I don't need to cast anything right now. And I can use shackles. Ooh, Mox Diamond is fantastic. Let's put back some lands. Because now with Mox Diamond, I could actually go Mox Diamond upheaval with no mana floating, but having not played a land. And then go land Mox Chalice for 1. Yeah, that sounds pretty good. Right, let's discard Island here. And let's cast Upheaval. And then go Island. Mox, discarding Island. Chalice for 1. Yeah, Mox Diamond's awesome. And I guess I can just discard a mountain here. So now my opponent, and an island. Probably going to keep the Ancient Tomb, I think, and the Sulfur Falls. So now my opponent's going to go, like, land Noble Hierarch at best, and then I can go land Jace, Bouncer, Noble Hierarch, next turn, Bouncer, Noble Hierarch, play Keranos, or I can go, actually, I can go Ancient Tomb, Shackles, take your Noble Hierarch. That also works, so opponent's not playing the Noble, just playing Temple of Mystery instead. That works for me, and then discarding millions of cards while I play a Jace. That also works for me. One of the most unpleasant parts about upheaval, besides the fact, you know, when you're facing it, that it's just an insane card, is that now my opponent's to choose and discard six cards. that's pretty awesome. It's just like, it's just so painful. You're just sitting there on one land. You know you're, like, I have three things in polarity. You know you're just going to lose this game, and you still have to discard millions of cards. So my opponent's discarding the Noble because of Shackles, I assume, which makes sense. Shackles... another card which is not the most fun to play against Overrun. Yeah, that card probably not going to do a whole lot. You also have to discard some lands. All right, Breeding Pool and Stomping Ground. So I knew about those. So my opponent has Opposition Kiora Nissa in hand, as well as, what, like a Taiga, a Sun Petal Grove. Opposition Kiora Nissa, Taiga, Sun Petal Grove. Probably another land that I know about. Alright, land. I think Jace is better to have out than Keranos. Anyway, draw three. Alright, let's just put lands back. So this way, when I play Keranos, I guess I get to rearrange my cards with Jace anyway. Alright, draw. Land. Keranos. Could have used Ancient Tomb to have Spell Pierce up, but I don't think I need to do that. Draw three. Frontline's kind of nice. Let's put back land, Vidalk, and Shackles. I don't really need to draw extra cards, so I want to put back Shackles so that I can shoot something for three when my opponent plays it. I assume my opponent's just dead here now. I mean, yep, they'd have to play something pretty good. All right. Get you. Island, and I think I actually play Gilded Lotus here. This way I can have Spell Pierce up. Not that it matters too much. All right, that's just plus on my opponent. No, you can keep Xenagos, and then I'll cast Vidalk and Shackles and pass the turn. Yeah, Mox Diamond made this all possible. Basically, it added two mana the turn I cast Upheaval, which is obviously more than enough. It's opposition. Purphoros, God of the Forge. Well, I can't spell pierce that, so I guess that's fine. Purphoros is a card. Purphoros is something that could potentially... cause me to lose. Greater Gargadon. Interesting. Am I close on animating Keranos? I guess I'm not. Four, I could go to five. Because I can play Gargadon. Let's go plus on Jace. And let's just play Inferno Titan. And so now my plan is to kill my opponent next turn. And yeah, I have more than enough to do that here. And Purphoros is dangerous, but unless my opponent has another, like, Siege Gang commander, then I'm not going to die to Purphoros. Because I can Spell Pierce any spell that puts multiple creatures into play. I could actually lose. I mean, Purphoros is one of the few cards in the game of Magic that I could lose to here, given that my opponent was on four lands and I had Spell Pierce in play. But it's a creature, and I had Shackles to and, you know, Keranos and Jace to protect me from creatures. But this is a creature that can just do eight to me without attacking. So I do have to kind of watch out for that. Like, my opponent goes land, deranged hermit, I guess I'm just dead. Which is kind of funny, but, you know, what can you do? I guess I could have played Inferno Titan last turn, but feels like I lose to a lot more that way. Alright, what you got? Xenagos the Reveler. No, let's Spell Pierce that. I don't think Xenagos would actually kill me here, but it feels like it's pretty safe to Spell Pierce it. Alright. Now I should be good, since now I even get to bolt off Keranos. Actually, Keranos is on six, so I could just animate Keranos to win the game. All right, well, actually, it's just had the win on the board anyway. All right, so this is the matchup where I would probably want Cunning Spark Mage and probably want Anger of the Gods. I assume that's better than Slagstorm. So if I'm doing that, I'm adding a mountain. And I could take out Legacies of Lore because my opponent's got a lot more 1-for-1 cards. It's definitely like Spell Pierce still. Definitely like Into the Royal Negate. I like almost everything else. Maybe I just don't play the Gargadon. Yeah, that sounds pretty good to me. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and keep this hand. Just turn 3 Cunning Spark Mage, just gotta be decent at least. If I draw Ancient Tomb, it could be a turn 2 or a Mox Diamond. Alright, Cunning Spark Mage is ready. It's a good card, not one I wanna draw now. Actually, I should have played Mountain in case I drew Ancient Tomb. Oops. Well, hopefully I draw Mox Diamond. Alright, Suspended Ancestral Vision. Alright. Spell Pierce not so great against that. Though Spell Pierce was a great draw, because now one of the ways I lose this game is my opponent plays like a Xenagos or a Kiora here, and I get to Spell Pierce that. Right on out of here, then kill the bird, which is pretty nice. Huntmaster. I can't Spell Pierce that. Alright. Well, may lose this game, because now my opponent doesn't have to play anything. In fact, may not be able to without the bird, but yeah, I'm going to need to draw a Mana Accelerant here to get one of these cards out quickly, because right now my opponent can just hit me for 4 and then flip Huntmaster, killing Cunning Spark Mage, and that's a pretty big game. Yeah. I cannot stop that. Needed my opponent's 4 mana card to be something I could Spell Pierce here, because now I'm actually really close to dead. Going to 14. Oh, well, that at least helps. I mean, it would have been better to draw that last turn, but hey, better late than never. Whoa, what is this? Restoration Angel? And I still can't Spell Pierce it? Oh, come on. Alright, yeah, well, fair enough. My opponent's draw was, I'd say, pretty good against mine. Let's just put it that way. Well, yeah, I'm just dead here. Alright, fair enough. Jeez, that was a mauling. Does that change what I want to do here? Not really. I mean, maybe do I want Roast in my deck? That just doesn't seem that good. Stagger Shock? I don't think I want a second Wrath. Alright, this is fine. Alright, I would like to play first. Oh yeah, this hand's good. I was worried about the 2 land part, but I've got a Ponder, so I imagine things are going to go swimmingly. So far, the person who's mulligan has won the game, both games 1 and 2. So this is actually, and now my opponent mulligan. See, I shouldn't have said that. My opponent heard and has the technology. All right, let's just look for some lands. Ah, that does deliver. Sure. Yeah, why not? So my plan now is to go Island Go, and then Sulphur Falls Cunning Spark Mage. Kind of hope my opponent has a one drop here, because Cunning Spark Mage will devour it. And Condescend and Negate pretty much protect me. What's probably going to happen now, realistically, is my opponent's... Oh, no, it's not an Ancestral Vision. Man, I was so excited for a second. All right. I mean, I do have the Negate for that, so it's not the end of the world, but that is unfortunate. All right, so now the question is, do I play Vidalkin Shackles? I'm drawing a land, so it's not like I need to have this Condescend ready. Yeah, I'm going to run out the Shackles. I think it's a lot stronger just to have that in play. And my opponent's got a lot of 4-drops, not a lot of 3-drops. Plus, if my opponent does play, like, a Goblin Rabble Master here, that is fine with me. And so then now I get to have Shackles in play and my mana up, and I think that's good. I think it's better to have Shackles out than Cunning Spark Mage. So, we'll see how this plan goes. Alright, yeah, you know, I am actually okay with that, because now I get to steal Rabble Master. And the goblin power will be mine. Because now I have Negate up, too, and Condescend. Alright. That works for me. My opponent's got visions on 2, so it's going to 1 here. I would like to negate the Ancestral Vision. Well, I can counter all of the powerful 4s here. Yes, Huntmaster will be Condescended. And bottom. Yeah, I'm going to keep Spell Pierce. My opponent just has a lot of cards that they get hit by it here. I'll not untap. Let's say land. Actually, don't think I play Cunning Spark Mage yet. Even if my opponent wants to block one of the goblins here, that's fine. Because I want to negate the Ancestral Vision. And then I want to spell pierce the 4-drop my opponent plays. And especially now that Huntmaster is gone, there are just not that many creatures, you know, creatures that my opponent has that cost this much mana. Or my opponent showed me a lot of planeswalkers and a lot of cards that cost, you know, in the 4 to 5 mana range. So mostly planeswalkers, actually. So I think keeping spell pierce in order to stop those is worth it. Let's see what this is. Eternal Witness. All right, well, that is fine. And I guess get back Huntmaster at this point. Certainly can't get back Ancestral Visions. All right, so now, yeah, things are going pretty great for me now, since now I get to not untap that. Play Cunning Spark Mage. Spark Mage the Witness, and send for millions of damage. And with Cunning Spark Mage out, if my opponent blocks any of my goblins with Huntmaster or the token, I get to finish it off. So now my opponent plays Huntmaster, and I just get to keep the Rabble Master and attack with everything. Actually, what is this? Nissa? Oh. Spell Pierce is going to just end the game, actually. That's it. My opponent counted on being able to untap lands and play Huntmaster, and that is not it. So, there we are. I guess keeping the Spell Pierce worked out. As did Vulcan Shackle, since I didn't do anything else this game. Alright. As long as we fail to untap at Vulcan Shackles, I think we're in good shape.